true. We did know that.
I've said that Dr. Hatwick had never told me of his feelings on this subject.
And he's lying.
I guess you would have to make that assumption.
Then why does this report from your own agency, dated July 1976, list neurological complications as a possibility?
I think the consensus of the scientific community was that the evidence relating neurologic disorders to influenza immunization was such that they did not feel that this association was a real one.
You didn't feel it was necessary to tell the people that information?
I think that over the years we have tried to inform the American people as fully as possible.
As part of informing Americans about the swine flu threat, Dr. Sensor's CDC also helped create the advertising to get the public to take the shot.
Let me read to you from one of your own agency's memos planning the campaign to urge Americans to take the shot. The swine flu vaccine has been taken by many important persons, he wrote. Example, President Ford, Henry Kissinger, Elton John, Muhammad Ali, Mary Tyler Moore, Rudolf Nureyev, Walter Cronkite, Ralph Nader, Edward Kennedy, etc., etc. True?
I'm not familiar with that particular piece of paper, but I do know that at least of that group, President Ford did take the vaccination.
Did you talk to these people beforehand to find out if they planned to take the shot?
I did not know.
Did anybody?
I do not know.
Did you get permission to use their names in your campaign?
I do not know.
Mary, did you take a swine flu shot?
No, I did not.
Did you give them permission to use your name saying that you had or were going to?
Absolutely not. Never did.
Did you ask your own doctor about taking the swine flu shot?
Yes, and at the time he thought it might be a good idea. But I resisted it because I was leery of having the symptoms that sometimes go with that kind of inoculation.
So you didn't?
No, I didn't.
Have you spoken to your doctor since?
Yes.
And?
He's delighted that I didn't take that shot.
You're in charge. Somebody's in charge.
There are...
This is your advertising strategy that I have a copy of here.
Who's it signed by?
This one is unsigned. But you'll acknowledge that it was your baby, so to speak.
It could have been from the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare. It could be from CDC. I don't know. I'll be happy to take responsibility for it.
It's been 3 years now since you fell ill with GBS, right?
Right.
Has the federal government, in your estimation, played fair with you about your claim?
No, I don't think so. It seems to be dragging on and on and on, and really no end in sight that I can see at this point.
With respect to the cases of Guillain-Barré, allegedly...
Former Secretary of HEW Joseph Califano, too, was disturbed that there was no end in sight. So a year and a half ago, he promised that Uncle Sam would cut the bureaucratic red tape for victims suffering from GBS and would pay up quickly.
We shouldn't hold them to an impossible or too difficult standard of proving that they were hurt. Even if we pay a few people a few thousand dollars that might not have deserved it, I think justice requires that we promptly pay those people who do deserve it.
Who's making the decision to be so hard-nosed about settling?
Well, I assume the Justice Department is.
Griffin Bell, before he left?
Well, the Justice Department agreed to the statement I made. It was cleared word for word with the lawyers in the Justice Department by my HEW lawyers.
And that statement said, in effect?
That statement said that we should pay Guillain-Barré claims without regard to whether the federal government was negligent if they resulted from the swine flu shot.
I think the government knows it's wrong.
If it drags out long enough, that people will just give up. Let it go.
I am a little more adamant in my thoughts than my wife is, because I told Judy to take the shot. She wasn't going to take it, and she never had shots. And I'm mad with my government because they knew the facts, but they didn't release those facts because if they had released them, the people wouldn't have taken it. And they can come out tomorrow and tell me there's going to be an epidemic, and they can drop off like flies to Mexico. I will not take another shot that my government tells me to take.
Meantime, Judy Roberts and some 4,000 others like her are still waiting for their day in court.
I don't need another flu shot. I had a flu shot last year.
A swine flu epidemic may be coming.
Swine flu shot? Well, I don't know. I've been thinking about it.
It could make you very sick.
Swine flu? Man, I'm too fast for that to catch me.
You'll want to be protected.
I'm the healthiest 55-year-old you ever seen. Hey, I play golf every weekend.
Get a shot of protection. The swine flu shot.
Joe brought it home from the office. He gave it to Betty and one of his kids and to Betty's mother. But Betty's mother went back to California the next day. On her way to the airport, she gave it to a cab driver, a ticket agent, and one of the charming stewardesses. At school, Joe's kid gave it to some other kids, and Mrs. Merrill got it and gave it to her husband. In California, Betty's mother gave it to her best friend, Dottie. But Dottie had a heart condition and she died. But before she died, Dottie gave it to her girlfriend, the mailman, the paper boy, and the vet when she went to pick up her chihuahua.
If a swine flu epidemic comes, this is how it could spread. You'll want to be protected, especially if you're elderly or chronically ill. Get a shot of protection. The swine flu shot.